Can you imagine how bright it can be? Someone comes and blindfolds you. The person tries to you type maybe a blank thing on your arm on your eye, you can't see, right? And that person then pulls you in a dark room. That's what's being illustrated here. The world is covered in darkness, and the gross darkness the people. So you can imagine. But God, but the scripture does not end there. It then says, but the Lord. Do you know that a but nullifies everything that has been said before? Whenever you see a but, it means that nothing said before the but does not matter. It's just like someone who's asking for an apology, says, you know what, I'm really sorry for what I did, I really feel bad for what I did. But is that still an apology? No, right? But the person is saying, you know what, I am sorry, but the fault is yours. I am sorry, but I don't think I'm really sorry. I am sorry, but I don't think I'm supposed to be apologizing. So, but nullifies everything that you've said before. But here, so you think, of course, the world is covered in darkness. Of course, gross darkness is covering the people. But all this is no longer effective. Why? Because the Lord has risen upon you. You are the reason why there's a but here. Did you hear me? I said that the reason why there was a but in the scripture. Because of course the world is covered in darkness. And gross darkness is covering the people. But the Lord has risen upon you. In other words, God decided to reside in you. So this darkness will not stay as it is. The world will no longer be covered in darkness as much as it used to be before you came. Now that you are there, the darkness in the world is reducing. Imagine if you and you and you and all of us here, we make it a mission to light up the world. We make it our mission to improve whatever the world situation is. Imagine what will happen with the darkness. We have to leave. Why? Because the light has come. He says here, but the Lord has risen upon you, and his glory appears over you. Of course, the world is covered in darkness. It's not a lie. It's true. People are just committing suicide. They are depressed. They are poor. They are hungry. I don't know all sorts of darkness the world is enjoying. But because you have come, because you are in that class, because you are in that city, because you are in that family, the light of God has risen upon you. And you know, I want you to understand it. Do you know that some of you, your family has been kept and preserved by God because of you? Do you know that because of your presence in your family, or because of your presence maybe in your group, you know, your friends, your squad, those people, their things are going well because of you. Do you know that? I just want to let you know, you know, for me, the family that I come from, they are not people who are very, you know, spiritual. They go to church maybe once in, you know, who knows? But let me let you know that I understood that the moment I take time to speak the word of God over them, to pray for them, and you know, it used to be just a thing that I thought, you know what, maybe because I'm the one who's doing this for myself, you know, I know how to make things for myself, I know how to make myself prosper, I know how to heal myself, I know how to get rid of sickness, I know how to comfort money and money comes, I know. And I used to think I cannot do it for other people. That's what I used to think. But the Lord opened my eyes a few weeks ago and he said, but you have to start praying for them. You have to start doing for them what you do for yourself. You understand what I mean? If I wake up every morning to declare prosperity over my own future, to declare the word of God over my life, he said, do that for them too. And in 2 weeks, I saw a change. In 2 weeks, they started sending me money that I didn't need. The money that they kept sending 3 months ago. But because I took time to do for them what I do for myself. You pray for yourself, right? You declare the word of God for yourself, right? You speak the affirmations for yourself, right? The Lord told me, yes, you can do it for them too. You can wake up in the morning and open the affirmations and start declaring the word of God is working in their lives. Yes, themselves, they see the glory of God. Do it for them. Why? Because the Lord is trusting you with their preservation. Doesn't matter how small you, even if you are the youngest in your family, even if maybe your father is the one that doesn't listen to the voice of a lady or whatever, start doing it for them. Before long, you begin to see a change. Praise the Lord. How many here you've laid hands on yourself and you receive the healing? Or you prayed for yourself and you receive the healing? That's what we do, right? In fact, your first neighbor, that's what we do. We don't, for you, if I hear you and you're telling me that you are sick, I won't even pray for you. I'll just hang up the phone and I'll drop it and I'll say, okay, it's fine. Continue. Why? Because we've understood that we are the ones who carry the health. The health is inside of us. So if by any chance the devil tries to do any tricks on your body, you remind him who he is and you remind yourself who you are. You say, this body is the temple of the living God. Therefore, sickness will not stay in this body. In the name of Jesus, I come. make him do the prayer of salvation. I felt like it was the most difficult thing I ever had to do. But the day before I left, even I was supposed to go to the airport that day. You know, in an African home, they'll sit you down, right? They start telling you, you know, now that you're going to school, be a good child. Don't be doing this and don't be doing that. Remember the reason why you're going to Cyprus. That's what they do, right? Okay, maybe it's my own family, but you know, if you're still that age, even as long as you're still a child in that house, that's what they'll do to you. So it was one of those, and my parents sent me down, and they were talking, you know, be good when you're going there, make sure that you attend all your lectures. You know, I'm saying, yes, yes. Praise God. And then I knew that was the time that I was supposed to do it, because my whole family was there except my younger sister. So I sent them down and I told them, as much as I love you, and we're here on earth seeing each other being here, but I don't know what might happen tomorrow. My love for you should be good enough to cover you for eternity. Because you do not love someone if you don't get them born again. Because you only see them here on earth. When you born all them or maybe when Jesus comes, they'll go in hell, but you'll be near them. So if you love someone, and if you want to be with them for the rest of your life, for the rest of eternity, get them born again. Because if you don't, when you die, or when both of you die, that person will definitely go to you if you're not born again. Praise the Lord. So I told my friend that, you know what, I really love you, and my love is not just for this world. It's for me. You're also supposed to go into eternity with me. And I led them to Christ with tears in my eyes. I was crying. I don't know why I was crying, but I was crying. And I made them do the prayer of salvation. So now I know that they are born again. Now I know that they are children of God. And so when I pray for them, or when I'm declaring the word of God for them, if they are sick, they're not feeling well, I stand up and I maybe kneel by my bedside and I start declaring the word of God. Father, they are born again. Their bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit. They cannot be sick anymore. In the name of Jesus, they are the seed of Abraham. They carry the blessing. Why? Because I know that they are the seed of Abraham. I know that they are born again. I know that they are children of God. Praise God. So the first thing that you have to do for your family or for whoever is around you, get them born again. If you truly, truly, truly love them, get them born again. That's the best thing that you can ever do for someone. Give them salvation. So I want you to understand that you are the light of the world. The world is covered with God's darkness, but because you are there, things will change. Praise the Lord. So I want to challenge you. For some of you that feel like maybe you can only pray and the word of God can only work for you, only know. It can also work for your family, for those that you love. As long as they are children of God, as long as they are born again, declare the word of God over them. And before long, you begin to see results. The word of God is for doing. I challenge you. It's a challenge. Start praying for your family. Start declaring the word of God over your family. Words cannot die. Words are spirit. The moment you speak the word of God over someone's life, that word is going into that person's life to manifest that thing that you spoke about. Every day I declare that my family, they are experiencing a new season. A season of peace and prosperity. In the name of Jesus. Why? Because I understand that I'm a light. And lights are also made for signs and what? And seasons. So I wake up in the morning and begin to declare a new season for my family. If they themselves do not pray, it's okay. I will do the praying for them. Until they know how to get on their knees and pray for themselves. It's for you to do. Praise God. So I don't want you to be thinking you're too slow to effect it. No. As long as you're a Christian, you're born again, you know the Lord Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit is inside of you, you can pray and cause changes. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's just go back to Matthew chapter 5, verse 13. I want you to give me the Amplified Version. Amplified Version of Matthew chapter 5, 13. Down to... I'll tell you where to stop. Amplified. Okay, sorry, give me the message. The message translation. Praise God. It says, okay, can we all see the screen? We can, right? And I want you to read with me because some of you might not have the message translation. Let's read together here. It says, let me tell you why you are here. You are here to be salt sizzling that brings out the God flavors of this earth. Let's talk there. Did you see that? These are the words of Jesus. He said, let me tell you why you're here. He said, let me tell you why you are still alive. Let me tell you why I haven't taken you to heaven since
born again.
Let me tell you why that accident or that whatever thing that happened to you could not kill you. Let me tell you. Let me remind you of your age. Let me remind you why you are living. Let me remind you why you have air in your lungs. Let me remind you. Let me remind you why you are in that school. Because you're saying here, Tomo, let me tell you why you are here. It's a place. It's a place. So let me tell you why you are in that family. Let me tell you why you are in that cell. Let me tell you why you are in that job. Let me tell you why you are wherever you are, whichever place you are. Let me tell you why you are there. Praise God. And you say, you are here. You say, you are here to be salt seasoning that bring out the God flavors of the earth. There are so many good things in this world. So many. This world is full of the goodness of the Lord. The earth and everything that is in it belongs to God. And God is good. In Him there is no darkness, no shadow of turning. That is the God that you serve. So the world that you create, after God created the heaven and the earth in Genesis, He said that it was good. Right? So there are a lot of good things in this world. But why do people are distressed? Why do people are dying? Why do people are committing suicide? Why do people are not, things are not moving well for them? Why? It's because the salt is not doing its duty. For you as the salt of the earth, your part is to make sure that you season your world. It's make sure that you are effecting a change in wherever you are. He said, let me tell you why you are here. You are here to be the soul system that brings out the God favors, that brings out the good things that God has created on earth, that brings out the good things that other people don't see. Let me tell you, for us in the church, and I know some of you already are doing this, you know, when people are like, this island is like this, it's not like this. Let me tell you, there is good in this place. And some of us are already proving that we're proving that the earth has got some good flavor, some God flavors. Praise God. Why? Because you are in the salt. It's my duty to show the world that, you know what, it doesn't matter how dry the place may seem. So long as I am there, I am the one to bring out the God colors, the God flavors, the goodness of God. I will show you that no matter, there's no deal that is too dry for me. There's no deal that is too dry for you. As long as you're a child of God, there is nothing that is difficult. Why? Because you carry the blessing. I always say this, it's not about what's around you, it's about what's in you. You are a child of God. You are a king. Your words carry power. When you say things, when you declare things, they have to come to pass. You ever say, okay, I don't know, I went back then when I feel a time to waste. Praise God. I used to watch this series, you know, this ancient movies and whatever. And they have kings and all that and all that. And what I saw that when a king says something, the moment he says it, there are servants around him ready to bring him that thing that he wants. Even if he says, I want a glass of water, there are five people who bring him that water. That's how a king operates. The moment he gives the word, the moment he opens his mouth to just say something, there is someone who's ready to run and make sure that thing comes. And guess what? If you are born again, you are a Christian, you are a child of God. You've got servants. You've got those that are meant to minister for you. The Bible says that are they not all ministering spirits, referring to angels? And they excel in strength, those that hearken to the voice of God. In case you didn't know, I pray that one day, God will allow us to speak on the ministry of angels. Do you know that the duty of angels in your life is to make sure that the word of God comes to life? Comes to life in your own life. If you are hearing for the first time, let me repeat it. The duty of angels is to make sure that they do the word of God in your life. So when you wake up in the morning and you start declaring the word of God, the moment you wake up in the morning, you say, you know what, I'm a seed of Abraham. Good things, they belong to me in the name of Jesus. My gates are continually open to receive the word of nations. That's the word of God, right? As you're speaking it, the angels are running. They are running. Of my gates are continually open today. So that the blessing does not take too long for it to come. I'll say today. My gates are continually open today to receive the word of nations. Yes, today I'm experiencing the prosperity of God. Yes, today I'm living in sound health. Today, the blessing is for the now. So you wake up in the morning and you bring the blessing in your day. Don't go into a day that you've been spoken of. Don't go
The devil is not lazy.
At all. The devil is always, you know, if you read in Job, he says that the devil also appeared when the angels were reporting before God. And he asked him, what are you doing? You, where have you been? He said, I've been going to and fro on the earth. To and fro. He does not rest. To and fro. He's looking for someone to devote. To and fro. He's always, the devil is never lazy. So don't go into a day that you're not spoken about. Don't be lazy to speak into your future, but the devil is not lazy to destroy it. Did you hear me? Don't be too lazy to speak into your future. Don't be too lazy to speak into your life. Because the devil is not too lazy to destroy it. Thank you, Holy Spirit. No. Thank you, God. You know, as I'm speaking, I'm hearing, as I'm speaking, I'm hearing. The Lord is giving me this, an illustration. He says the words that you speak into your life, they are like a hedge. We all have a hedge, right? A hedge or something that is protecting, you know. Let's say maybe a wall, but the Lord is telling me a hedge, right? So that hedge is like when you speak into your life, when you speak into your day, what you're doing is you're creating a hedge. You're creating a hedge. All around you're creating a hedge, you're creating a hedge. So that whatever the devil may throw at you that day, it will not get to you. Why? Because you're protected. Do you hear me? The Lord is saying the word of God is like a hedge. That hedge that is surrounding you, that hedge that is protecting you. So that there was a woman who was about to die. Or she thought she was about to die. In fact, she was so sick that she said, you know what, Lord, it's better you take me. She was a Christian. She fell ill and she was like, Lord, it's better you take me. I don't want to live anymore. And this is what God said to her. He said, you cannot die yet. You have spoken too much life for you to die now. That's what the Lord told her. He said, you have spoken too much life. You've been speaking a lot of the word of life. You've been speaking too much. You cannot die now. Why? Because of the hell that is around you is too thick for the devil to penetrate. The hell that is around, the hell of the word of God that was surrounding that woman, it was too thick for even death to penetrate. Did you hear me? So the word of God is like a hedge. Every day when you wake up in the morning, create your hedge. Increase your hedge. Increase your hedge. Increase the covering of the word around your life. So that whenever the devil may try his tactics, your hedge is too thick for him. Your hedge is too thick for sickness. Your hedge is too thick. Okay, even if the devil tries to draw sickness, that sickness will just bounce back on the hedge of the word of God. The word of God is like a hedge. You speak it into your life. He said, I was just laying on my bed, and I'm like, Lord, you know, sometimes it's really exhausting for me to wake up every morning and start speaking the word of God. Sometimes I'm always in a rush. You know, I was just talking, you know, me and God, we just be chilling and just be talking then. And he said, okay, if you think speaking the word of God is too, I don't know, hard or it's too, it takes too much time, have you ever been lazy to breathe? You wake up one morning, you're just too lazy to breathe. You're like, you know what? Today I'm not going to be breathing. I'm just tired. I can't. I just don't want to breathe today. Who has ever woken up that day and did that? You don't, right? Because you know you want to live. So you cannot be tired of breathing because you have to live. So you cannot afford not to speak the word of God into your life. Why? Because what you're doing is you're simply inviting death. Because Jesus said, these words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The word of God is food to your spirit. So it does not matter how late or how tired you are to speak. Just consider it. Just think of this. Just think of this illustration. You are never tired to breathe. You are never tired. Praise God. You have to breathe because you have to live. The same thing with the word of God. You have to speak because you have to live. If you stop speaking the word of God, I don't know what will happen to you. I don't know. I only want to imagine it. So if you want to breathe, as badly, you cannot even spend your nostrils closed. Why? Because you have to breathe. The same thing with the word of God. Just speak the word of God. Get to a point where the word of God becomes like air to you. You cannot, that day will not go well without you studying or meditating the word of God. Without you speaking the word of God forth into your life. Why? Because it's nice. Praise the Lord. The word of, you know, if you read, I think it's a proverb. It says, the word of God is medicine and life to those that find it. Just to show that the word of God, the moment you speak forth the word of God, it's as good as you are taking in breath into your body. As much as you need air, you need the word. If you still, as long as you are still breathing, you still need the word of God. to speak the word of God into your life. You need to speak for things. Why? Because it's as important as breathing. Speaking into your own life, affirming the word of God into your own life and the life of your loved one is as important as breathing. No two ways about it. I will not end or decrease from it. It's as important as breathing. Hallelujah. Yes, but you know, this time is flying. I don't know where it's flying to, but let me just round up by saying this. When I started, I said, God trusts men with missions, right? God wants to do something. He needs a man. He looks for someone who can do the thing that he wants to do in a particular area, in a particular time. Praise God. Hallelujah. And for those that were around during the EEP, you heard that we are now an independent Christ Embassy Church. Somebody shout glory! And that comes with a lot of work. Praise God. It means we have to start functioning as we ought to. Praise God. And let me just let you know that, just as I told you, that God over time, He trusts people with visions and missions, things that He wants them to do. He trusts people with them. And over 30 years ago, the Lord trusted our man of God, Pastor Chris. PhD, DD, DSD. Is that what they say? Praise God. So much more, and I know so many doctorates and whatever. You know, I love my man of God. I don't know about you. He's the one who has made us relevant in ministry. He's the one, it's because of him that we've got the church in Fua. Praise God. I want to read back to you the vision. The character of the Spirit. The nations and people of the world, and to demonstrate the character of the Spirit. Hallelujah. That is the mission that God gave Pastor Chris. That is the mission that we ourselves are functioning under. Because do you know that it's because of someone that wanted to take the presence of God to their world and to the people of the nation of this world. That's the reason why you are here. It's because someone had to take the presence of God to involve. You know what? I want you to come to our church. And that's how you came into contact with this vision. And now you are part of that vision. So God is trusting Pastor Chris to take the presence, the divine presence of God, to the nations all over the world. I don't know what God gave other ministers and ministries, but this is the vision that we are running with. It's our duty to take the divine presence of God all around the world. Do it like no one else is doing it. Do it like only you can do it. Hallelujah. I don't know why the time is flying as much as it's doing, but I think we'll continue from here next week. I will let you know about this is the vision. I'll let you know of the mission, and I'll let you know of the purpose. Praise God. Why you do the things that you do. All that we're doing, the rattle of reality, the healing school, everything, the ritual campaign, everything that we're doing is for the same vision. To make sure that you are taking the presence of God to the nation and the people of the world. Why? Because they need it. The world needs God. Without God, the world is dying. Hallelujah. Did you feel something today?
Yes.
So even as you come to this service and this meeting, know that you are coming to collect the word of God for your world. Did you hear me? As you are coming to change every Sunday for your soul meeting, whatever that you are doing, or even your choir rehearsal, so know that you are going there to take the presence of God and bring it to your world. The divine presence of God. Hallelujah. Let's rise upon our feet. Now, I want us to spend some time to thank God for the word that has come to your spirit this morning, this afternoon. Go ahead and thank God. Thank Him all by yourself. Thank Him that this word is producing results in your life. Thank Him that the word of God, as you speak it into this week, is bringing forth results in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and speak to God. God, go ahead and thank Him. Go ahead and be grateful for all the word that you've had today. Go ahead and speak to your Father. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you.